हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल. दिस इज लता वर्थ, वर्किंग एज अ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री एट KVN 9 आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज कैनाडा कॉर्नर नासिक. इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द फ्री रेडिकल इंट्रामोलिकुलर साइक्लाइजेशन रिएक्शन. बिफोर वी प्रोसीड, लेट अस रिवाइज व्हाट वी लर्न इन लास्ट लेक्चर. सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर we discuss about the way of making free radical by the mercury method, its reaction and mechanism involved in it. By taking one example, and lastly we take other example and we saw its mechanism. But in this mechanism, when this radical attack on this double bond, these bond open on this carbon and generation of free radical takes place here. So in next step, these radical abstract hydrogen radical from this alkyl mercury hydride. And we get here Hg plus this radical, and our product is like that. Here is your methyl. Now we will discuss intramolecular free radical cyclization reaction. The intramolecular radical reactions are more efficient than intermolecular one. All of the reaction which are discussed so far involves radical attack between two molecules. We have pointed out of some of the drawbacks when carbon-carbon bond are made in this way, in which first is the radical trap has to be activated and must be present in excess, and second is the radical starting material must contain very weak carbon X bond such as carbon bromide, carbon iodide and carbon mercury bonds. The requirements are much less, however, if the radical reaction is carried out intramolecularly. For example, this reaction works when this moiety is treated with TbTH in presence of AIBN, we get this cyclic product in 75% yield, and the mixture of distereomers. Notice that the double bond is not activated, in fact it is nucleophile, and the reaction still works even though the radical is also submitted with an electron donating group. The carbon sulfur bond that is broken is also relatively strong, and the high yield of the product is obtained. Thus the question arises that why should this happen? What difference does it make that the reaction are intramolecular? Mechanism of this reaction is like that. The AIBN and TBTH reacts with each other and we get tributyl teen radical. In next step, the tributyl teen radical is reacts with given moiety that is and formation of new radical take place, but this carbon sulfur bond is relatively strong and here we get minus SPH and teen tributyl and here we get new radical. The oxygen atom lone pair rises so much energy and nucleophilic radical adds to the electron rich double bond. So this radical is attacked on this double bond and here formation of new radical take place. New radical take place. In next step, this radical abstract hydrogen radical from the TBTH and we get in 75% yield. Remember that when we are carrying out radical reaction intermolecularly, that is in two different molecules, addition to the radical trap was encourages by increasing the concentration of radical trap, that is alkene, and decreasing the concentration of teen hydride to the avoid radical reduction. For intramolecular reaction, the double bond that acts as a radical trapping, that is radical trap, is always held close to the radical and cyclization take place extremely rapidly even on the unactivated double bond. This bond is unactivated. The teen hydride does not get look in and can be present in the higher concentration would be possible. As there is only one equivalent of radical trap and the trap not be highly reactive, there is little dangerous of high concentration of teen radical reacting with it. So the concentration of teen radical can build up the level where the rate of abstraction of group like chloride, SPH and SCPH is acceptable as the bond is stronger. Now we will see why intramolecular radical reactions are so good. The radical and radical trap are part of the same molecule. Therefore, radical trap always held close to forming radical and the radical trap cannot be present in excess. The radical trap always held close to forming radical, therefore trapping is very fast. The trapping is very fast, therefore the radical is not reduced by tin hydride and the trap does not need to be highly reactive. When the radical is not reduced by tin hydride, then the larger concentration of tin hydride can be present. When the larger concentration of tin hydride can be present, the concentration of tin radical can be higher. When the trap does not need to be highly reactive and the radical trap cannot be present in excess, then there is no danger of addition of alkyl tin radical to the trap, and therefore the concentration of tin radical can be higher. And along with that, therefore weaker carbon X bond can be used as a radical sources. If you like this video, then press like button, share with your friends, and to get notification of new videos, subscribe my channel. Thank you. Thank you for watching.